Hi, and welcome to this new Quick Tech episode. My name is Philippe Poziel. I'm a developer advocate at Salesforce. And in today's episode, I'm going to tell you how we onboard developers on our sample apps. Sample apps are a great way to bundle code snippets and tell a story at the same time. Plus, it plays very nicely with traditional documentation. At Salesforce, we've built a gallery that contains 8 sample apps that have been used by thousands of developers. Let's take eCars, for example. An app that demonstrates how a fictitious car manufacturer built a sales and service application with various components from the Salesforce platform. Users can navigate on this tile to get access to the app's GitHub repository. In the repository, users have access to the source code and the install instructions. Once users have installed the app, you still need to onboard them and show them around the app. You can do this with different techniques, with the README, a video, but we found something that is way more engaging to users and interactive. You can use guidance within the app itself or within an IDE. This is why our sample apps use both in-app and in-code guidance to deliver a great onboarding experience. For in-app guidance, we use a Salesforce feature that lets us record introduction tours that guides users around the app with a series of pop-up dialogues. We use the tours to present business use cases and highlight key features. In combination with in-app guidance, we use CodeTour, a Visual Studio Code extension that provides guided tour to sample apps source code within the Visual Studio Code IDE. CodeTour works in a similar way as in-app guidance. It's a series of configurable pop-ups that we use to present the architecture of the app and highlight the most important pieces of code. User interface supports Markdown, so you can easily place code samples and documentation links. Tours can be recorded with a built-in user interface or by editing a JSON file. Code tours are tied to files and line numbers, so there's a chance that they get out of sync when you change your code base. And we've addressed this risk with a code tour watch custom GitHub action that runs in our CI workflow. The action helps us track and manage consistency by warning us when it detects code changes that impact our tours. I'm going to leave you with 3 tips on how to create the best developer onboarding experience ever with in-app guidance and in-code guidance. Tip number 1, keep your tours concise. Analytics indicate that users tend to drop off when there are more than 5 steps in a tour or when there is too much information in each step. Tip number 2, add links to documentation. You want users to navigate across different developer resources to get the most knowledge as possible. Get bonus points if you also add links to your sample apps within your documentation. Tip number 3, suggest user interactions to make step more actionable. You're not writing documentation or recording a video, so take advantage of the interactive format. Besides, people tend to learn better when they practice. And that's a wrap. Thanks for watching this developer's quick take. If you enjoyed this content, make sure to click like on the video. And if you'd like more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notified as we release new videos. Thank you.